The insect cuticle is a rigid external skeleton that covers the outer surface of the insect. This cutaway view shows that the cuticle consists of a series of layers. Epidermal cells are the living part of the cuticle. They form the single layer below the structural layers of the cuticle. The epidermal cells secrete all the structural layers of the cuticle with the exception of the outermost cement layer, which is a product of the dermal glands. The structural cuticle is divided into a thick inner cuticle and a thin outer epicuticle. The thick inner cuticle is divided into the exocuticle and the endocuticle. Both the exocuticle and endocuticle are comprised of cross-linked chains of chitin and protein. Insect cuticles are rigid and hard because the outer exocuticle has undergone a process called tanning, similar to the tanning of leather. Tanning makes the exocuticle hard and stable, so it is resistant to chemicals and abrasives. The thick inner endocuticle does not undergo tanning. The epicuticle consists of three layers: an innermost cuticulin layer, a middle wax layer, and an outermost cement layer. For our purposes, the wax layer is of greatest interest, since it is the layer of the cuticle that protects the insect from water loss. Waxes are a mixture of fatty acids and alcohols, and the wax layer consists of two layers: an inner organized layer of single wax molecules called the monolayer, and a thick outer layer of randomly mixed wax molecules. It is the water-repellent ability of the wax layer that protects the insect from excessive water loss. It is believed that the innermost cuticulin layer has properties that cause nearby wax molecules to form into the monolayer of oriented single molecules. The outermost cement layer is a mixture of fats and proteins and is variable in both its presence and thickness, and its role is uncertain, but it may protect the waxes from abrasion. Finally, the procuticle is penetrated by fine tubules called pore canals. The pore canals appear to enclose cytoplasmic projections of the epidermal cells and other filamentous tubules that extend to the epicuticle. The pore canals probably transport chemicals, possibly the waxes, from the epidermal cells to the procuticle and the epicuticle. Pore canals may also provide an avenue for certain chemicals to enter the insect, such as insecticides. The cuticle of the grasshopper was used to illustrate cuticle structure. However, some insect species have soft bodies, for example, aphids, whiteflies, thrips. Immature forms of leafhoppers. Early larval stages of many insect species that have hard bodies as adults. And other small insect-related pests, such as the red spider mite. Soft-bodied insects have thinner procuticles and exocuticles that are less tanned. Because of their thinner cuticles, soft-bodied insects are especially susceptible to rapid dehydration if their wax layer is damaged. Let us see why insects in general have a problem with water balance and how the wax layer protects against excess water loss.